Let's talk about math.
Yeah.
There's no way anybody, with given the fiscal constraints, can make the decisions they will always want to make, and they have to make tough decisions.
Yeah.
I'm curious from your end, of programs either you've cut or funding that you've cut back on, what was the most difficult one that you've made?
Well, I think the thing that's gotten the most publicity, but it was the right decision, and it was done in a bipartisan way each step of the way, Democrats supported it, was the child care. You know, we had $2.5 million underfunded in the budget, so in debt, that program. Almost all of that program is something that we choose to do. We don't have to do it. The only child care subsidies we have to provide are those that are at or below the poverty level. That's a federal requirement, and we use federal dollars for that. Everything above that is something we choose to do, and it's the right thing to do. But we are much more generous than New York City charges for same income families. They charge 35%, we charge 27%. Is it a hardship for some? It might be. But it's trying to find that balance and fairness between what we can afford, that's the taxpayers, and what the needs are.
Difficult decisions have to be made, but the criticism has been that where you found the savings or the cuts have been disproportionately on the backs of those that can least afford it. And there's a couple other examples. You mentioned, obviously, the child care subsidies, but the WRO to help people that are looking at foreclosure. And the cuts to that program, they say, might be penny wise, pound foolish, where those people then are going to go on other, you know, county subsistence programs. Also, program I'm familiar with, I know you are too, Westchester Food Bank.
Mm-hmm.
They had a cut, as did other food service agencies that helped out those neediest. We both know, great organization,
yeah,
that delivers a ton of needed food in communities. I can tell you they personally are feeling the hit as well. What about that theme that the bottom here of the county are paying the biggest price with the belt tightening?
Well, let's talk about the middle class and everybody else who have to pay as well. And that has to come into focus because it is not an endless supply of money. And every time, and you know, it's the highest tax county in America, and people legitimately are feeling after they've lost their job or they've had less income or their value in their 401ks are less, you know, they can't take it anymore. And so are grandparents going to move to Florida and Skype or FaceTime their grandchildren? That's what it's coming down to, and we want to keep people here. So we have to find that balance. You know, I think it's very important, and we have kept the level in Department of Social Services even, actually added a little more over the last 4 years. That's not the case in a lot of our other departments. I led the way, 19% gone from my county executive's staff. But I don't agree that we have balanced the budget on the backs of the poor. That's the old line used by anyone who wants more and more and more money. We have made sure we had the right balance, a healthy balance between the needs, and there are plenty, and what we can afford.
There's much that's in a county executive's job description, but he doesn't make much as it relates to social policy. However,
right,
a lot of attention has been paid, and I spoke to your counterparts running in Nassau County along these same lines, as to, especially today with all the attention in Washington of the back and forth, where you stand on particular issues, and you know your county and the registration, slightly more Democratic, not substantially more Democratic than Republican. You're pro-life,
mm-hmm,
and as it relates to gay marriage, as far as I'm clear on it, you don't support the premise of gay marriage. Can you give the rationales as to why, and do you think it matters if that's out of step with the general population of your county?
I think you should ask the voters, because in 2005 it was the same issues thrown against me. In 2009 it was the same issues thrown against me. And in 2013 it's the same old tired playbook. You know, I have personal views. These are issues that we don't deal with. You're right. You know, the state ruled and gay marriage is legal here. My respect for the LGBT community is very well known.
Well before Newtown, but even before that, the issue of guns.
Yeah.
There was a 10-year moratorium on gun shows,
yeah,
at the county center. You lifted that. Now, I know you, after Newtown, you stopped gun shows,
right,
there. But why did you lift it? And secondly, will you tell the audience that if reelected, there will or won't be another gun show in the county?
I would consider it if we got a request, and here's why. We have the protocols that the state adopted for gun shows. We were not going to allow a gun show to take part in the county center unless there were serious safety precautions. ATF, FBI, county police are there. Everyone has to sign that if any sale is outside the county center, it's an immediate arrest. Every sale has a background check. Now, these are things that we instituted before we allowed them to come in. This was ahead of the time. Since then, Governor Cuomo has allowed gun shows in state facilities and adopted the same precautions. Gabby Giffords and Attorney General Schneiderman, two Democrats, were just at a gun show in Saratoga 2 weeks ago, and they applauded the safety precautions that the Westchester County put in the gun shows, which are now adopted as part of the SAFE Act. So again, a balance, and can it happen? Yes, because of what is in there. What Noam Bramson is saying is just ludicrous. Look, there is no reason why a military-style, fully automatic assault weapon should be on the streets with anybody. I mean, that's ridiculous. But, you know, you're talking about law-abiding citizens who go through a major background check, criminal background check, in order to have a pistol permit. These are not only family people, these are victims of domestic violence. You have small business owners. You have law enforcement, retired and active. These are good law-abiding citizens. They should not be demonized. And as part of the SAFE Act, I mean, as part of what happened in Newtown, we initiated safer communities. Now, that's something that's real. That's something where we're actually making schools safer and neighborhoods safer. We joined with the city of Mount Vernon. County police went in this summer. We broke up gangs. We took illegal guns and drugs off the street. Mm-hmm. 250 arrests. We have a school resource officer now as part of this in Somers and in North Salem and in Ossining. So these are real things that we're doing to make schools safer and communities safer.
Finally, we live in a day and age of political labels. Fair or not, we do. And I'm curious, if a Westchester resident came up and said, Rob, I'm a Tea Party person and I see a lot of myself in you, would you take that as a compliment or an insult?
You know what? I am who I am. I've worked, and I despise what happened in Washington, by the way. And I spoke out before the closure and asked them to act like adults and not clowns, to speak to one another. That's what we do here. Remember, I had 13 Democrats, 4 Republicans when I walked in the door. There's now 10 Democrats, 7 Republicans. So I couldn't get anything done, let alone a unanimous budget that compromised on everything and did not raise taxes without Democratic support. So we work in a bipartisan way. We have disagreements, but we actually communicate. And that has not happened in Washington, D.C. You know, it's very interesting because the founder of the Westchester Tea Party is the supporter of Noam Bramson and working on his campaign. He has endorsed Noam Bramson. But look at who I have the endorsements from. The League of Conservation Voters. Two chairmen of the NAACP local chapters, New Rochelle and Yonkers. The labor unions, 40 labor unions, because of what we've done been getting jobs back and on the Tappan Zee Bridge. We have the endorsement from Hispanic law enforcement and almost all law enforcement. So if you look at that and I'm judged on what we've done, I think that's a better indicator than, again, garbage coming out of the other side in the last 4 weeks of a campaign.
And okay. I wish you the best of luck on
you,
Tuesday.
Thank you very much.
All right, everybody. When we come back, we're going to hear from the counterpart, Democratic challenger Noam Bramson. Please stay with us.